Hi, this is Leslie Robbins with the Readiness Team, and I am here with Senior PM Craig Moss, and he is going to walk us through a deep dive of the Dynamics 365 modernization for ARC, also known as the automatic record creation, and go over the updated rules functionality for this. Hi, Craig.
Well, Leslie, thanks very much. So today I'll be going through ARC, which is automatic record creation and update rules functionality. We've migrated from the web client version into the unified client. This feature is an admin functionality, and it allows you most often to convert an incoming email into a case. So I'll walk through that conversion process and then kind of highlight different points in the advanced functionality pieces as we go through. So to start with, the admin capability is in the customer service hub sitemap. So this is the user sitemap. Since it's admin functionality, we go under service management. And now in the list, it's down here under case settings. So the default grid will show you any of your pre-existing ARC rules that you have in draft or active mode. So the status would show up here. So since I haven't created any yet, that's what the purpose of this meeting's for. There's none listed, but we'll go ahead and create one, and we'll come back here at the end and show that it's activated and how you can tell. So let's go ahead and get started. We'll go ahead and click new to get going. So as the very first information we need is to give the rule a name. So we'll just call this a test rule. The queue that we're going to monitor. So this is where we want to scope the focus of the monitoring. So in this case, I've created a support queue in advance. So we're going to monitor the activity that we select when it appears in the queue that we're monitoring. So in this case, we have email that we're going to be monitoring, but you can select any of the existing activities from the list to monitor those as well. But we're going with email. At this point, we have our basic information required to save the rule. So we'll go ahead and click on save. That'll activate our ability to enter the conditions we want to evaluate. So I'm going to walk you through creating two very basic conditions. The first one will be to check for a specific word in the subject line of the incoming email that we're monitoring. And then the second one will be to check for a different keyword on the subject line, and it'll take a different action. So, well, let's get going, and I'll kind of explain as we go the differences between these two. So we click on new. Opens a little a dialogue that we can now enter our first conditions to check. So I'm going to call this check for help in subject. So and just understand, I'm creating a very simplistic condition here. However, as you can tell in this dropdown, we have every field within email, the activity that we're monitoring, that we can test against. So I'm just picking the subject line to test against. You can create super complex rules and you can join. You have multiple functionalities where you can group multiple conditions together. You can create and or combinations. You're really building a criteria match that you evaluating everything either will come out as true or false. And if it comes out as true, so in the case we're creating, if the subject line contains the word help, then these are the actions to take. And so for this, we're going to create a case. However, you can literally create any type of entity record within Dynamics. So you have a very large list to pick from, and there's just like, but the normal case is email the case. So we're creating the case for this one. In the next condition, we'll create a different kind of entity record just to show you that you can select something else. So now we integrate with Power Automate. So that's actually extends capabilities for more advanced usage. And so for basic, you don't really have to do much for a case creation, but I want to walk you through and show you what Power Automate looks like. So when you load Power Automate, the title of the condition will be up here in the upper left. So if we go right back, we'll see we've created the rule, check for help in subject. And now in our Power Automate, we have check for help and subject. These are the steps of the rule. So there's first one where it actually creates a holding spot for identifying the customer, and then it actually runs logic to determine what type of customer they are, whether they're a contact or an account. And then at that point, it will can exit if it's not a validated contact and you haven't allowed for a non-validated account to move forward. Or if it is, then it goes ahead and will create the case. So the reason to go into Power Automate is to verify that all your required fields are populated. So in for a case, that is done for you. For every other entity record, you need to go in and do it yourself. So for the case, the subject line of the email becomes the title of the case, and then the from, whoever sent you the email, becomes the customer in the case. So that's what these pre-populated values are. As you can see in here too, there's a lot of fields. So you could actually put static text in any of these as you wished, or you could have dynamic lookup data where you picked other fields from the email record and populated data in here as well. And you can, as you learn more about Power Automate, there's formulas, there's all different calculations that can be done. All that capability exists for you to take advantage of. So let's go ahead and save. And then we can go back over here. We can close our condition, refresh, and we'll see that in the grid. So now I'm going to create a second condition. So conditions are evaluated in the order they appear from top to bottom. So I'm going to add another one. So this one, I'm going to check for support in subject. So this, we're just going to look same basic type of rule, which is just testing for a keyword in the subject line of the email. But this time we will subject contains, and we're going to look for the word support, like I need support. But if it was, so interestingly, if it was I need help from support, help would be the first condition that would be checked. And so a case would be created. However, if only support exists in the subject line, then instead of doing a case, we're going to go ahead and what should we do? Opportunity instead. So this would be most likely used for like a sales type of scenario. But let's say there's some condition that you wanted to test for, and instead of creating a case to respond back to the customer in like a helpful exchange, you wanted to create a future contact opportunity for the customer. So this is a way you could do that. You could have conditions that evaluated the incoming email and said, oh, they don't need something urgently. They're just asking like a feature type of question or something. So there's an opportunity for us to reach out to them, but without the same level of urgency that you might have for a support issue or so a broken functionality. So in this case, for opportunity, I now go into Power Automate, and we'll take a look at the difference now. So before we were creating a case and the title of the case was being pre-populated, as was the customer's from. So now we have check for support in the subject. You'll notice that some of the additional checks aren't there. And at this point, there are no values pre-populated. So in here, there's some fields for opportunity that actually are required, which one of them happens to be currency, and I don't know why, but whatever. So we'll say USD, and then topic, we'll just put a static text string that says test topic in there. So that'll satisfy the creation criteria. These are the three required fields. Again, there's many fields. You could populate them as you wish or as you need. And then when we're done, we'll click save, and then we'll go back into record, we'll close it. And so this, and then we'll hit refresh again. So at this point, we now have the very first conditions that'll be checked or to see whether or not there's help in the subject. If there is, we're gonna go ahead and create the case. And then if there is no help in the subject line of the email, we'll check to see if there's the word support in the subject line. And if there is, we'll create an opportunity. Again, these are artificial like conditions, but I hope it kind of illustrates you have a lot of functionality. You can order them. So if you wanted to actually preemptively check for support and create an opportunity before you actually created a case. You would just change the order here. So you have a lot of flexibility. So once you have all the conditions and the sequence correctly set up, then the final step here for basic flow is to actually determine whether or not you want to automatically respond with an email when the conditions are met above. And so if you do, you would then toggle this to yes, and then you would actually take a look for an existing template. And so let's say, we're going to say case autoresponse. This is a very generic out of the box template that just validates a case has been created. Lets a customer know, hey, we got what you sent us and we're going to do something about it. And at that point you can go ahead and save. And now we could go ahead and activate. But before we activate, I want to highlight there are some advanced capabilities as well. We moved those over to a separate tab because generally, when you're using ARC for like email the case, these aren't settings you generally need to use. However, they are available for you. And these are the same parity functionality from the web client experience as well. So the very first setting, before evaluating conditions. So what this is saying is before we actually try to evaluate the inbound email, we need to make sure that these conditions pass successfully. Or else we won't continue forward in evaluating the rule. So the first one is creating rules for emails from unknown senders. So by default, it only allows emails to be received from senders who are known to the dynamic system of your business. So it would be pre-existing customers. So you would toggle this to yes if you had customers, like new customers that weren't in the system yet, or you were holding your customer database elsewhere. And so Dynamics wasn't necessarily or didn't need to be directly aware of them as a contact or an account. So it's a valuable functionality to be able to enable if you need to, but not a requirement and normally not necessary to have turned on. Because normally you have known customers, you're having them respond to you for like support type of cases. But an opportunity or something that's more sales, where you're trying to be proactive in reaching out, maybe you would want to toggle that on. The only downside of that is if like spam type of emails also are allowed to come in as a result, like people can browse and find email addresses and just use that as an entry point. So that's the only thing to kind of gauge against. And you can always toggle it back off if you find you're getting undesired email volumes into a queue. So the other thing is requiring valid entitlements. So some businesses choose to use entitlements to limit how many like cases can be created for a given customer or for a given like product they're providing support for. And so this would be something that you would toggle on if that were the relevant for your business. And then the last one is the to avoid accidentally creating multiple cases for inbound emails. So the way Dynamics works is once a case or the regarding record is resolved, from Dynamics' point of view and from ARC's point of view, it's as if it never existed. And so an incoming email in response to that resolved case would just be treated like an entirely new email and a new case would be created, unless you said, wait a specific amount of time, and then you specified like, hey, I'm gonna wait one day after I resolve it before treating things as if they're all new. And the reason you do this is if an agent, like in a support scenario, a customer has raised an issue, you have your support team that's responded back, they're exchanging emails back and forth. At the end, the support team says, thank you very much, we're resolving your case. And then 4 hours later, the customer says, thank you. You don't want that to create a new case and start the process again. So this allows you to delay and ignore that thank you coming back, and it just gets tracked back into that original case that was created. So, but again, normally, not really, this is more higher volume, where it's more disruptive to have those extra cases created. If you're in a slower volume or less an intense number of cases, I don't think it's as relevant, but it's available to you. And that's why we put it under the advanced tab. It's just not as frequently used. The last setting in here is who the owner is. By default, it's the admin who actually creates the rule. And it's also the security context that the rule runs under. So since it's an admin functionality, basically anybody who can create a rule should be able to execute under their credentials just fine. But that can be shifted if you have a specific account that you've created where you want to run all your rules using that security context. So that's available. And those are all the advanced. Now, depending on what you're monitoring, the options under advanced may change because a couple of these are very email centric. But the one that'll always be there is going to be the owner permissions. But the other ones can vary depending on which activity type you're actually choosing to monitor. So at this point, now we're ready to activate it. So we'll go ahead and click on activate. And then that warning message that I just went glossed right over was, if you had a pre-existing rule that was monitoring emails on the support queue and it was active, it would deactivate that rule before activating this rule. So you're just accepting that that's going to happen. And so we're now, since we don't have a pre-existing rule, it's just activating the rule we created, and then it will begin monitoring, and it's going to monitor for any incoming email on the support queue, testing for the subject line containing either the word help or the word support, and then taking the configured actions for each. So once it's activated, you'll see the read-only banner appear. And then if you go back to the main list where we started all this, you'll see that the status is now active. So test rule, monitoring email activity on the support queue is in an active state. So at this point, as emails come into the support queue, they would be evaluated and action taken on a matching criteria. And that is automatic record creation and update rules feature for our April release. Back to you, Leslie.
Thanks, Craig. I appreciate you taking the time to walk us through this. I have an echo. If you like the video, please make a comment at the bottom and let us know if there's any more details that we could provide on this. We're happy to come back with some additional information and go into a deeper dive on those specifics, and please let us know in the comments below. Thank you, Craig. This was awesome and incredibly helpful.
Great. Thanks, Leslie.